According to this topic, I understand that when you read any specific then you read any topic, like you read any story topics, first you read, then you think about why writers write these things. First and the second option, and then story books, then you complete read the story and think why writer write these things in this story.
All right, what are the techniques of reading?
Ma'am, there are mainly three techniques of reading.
What are they?
Ma'am, first one you read your passage, and the second one you think related words then come in your passage, and the third one why writer write this thing.
Okay, you start thinking why has he written this?
Yes.
Why is reading called a guessing game? Psycholinguistic guessing game. Why? Psycholinguistic guessing game, I already discussed in the last class. It means you start thinking why the writer may have written this. You guess.
Something done in her life.
Yes.
Issues.
Everybody writes with experience. So you start guessing why a particular writer has written this. It is a guessing game. Right? Yes, next. Kamini Kumari. Understand by the term we read between the lines.
Ma'am, जब हम लोग lines के बीच में read करते हैं, तो हम लोग उस समय writers के views, point of view को समझने की कोशिश
करते हैं. कुछ लिखा हुआ है वो समझते हैं, जो नहीं लिखा हुआ है वो भी हम लोग guess करने की कोशिश करते हैं. We read between the lines what the writer is wanting to see. Yes, continue.
Also, there are technique of reading which is known as SQ3R. S means survey, Q means questions, read R for read, and second R for recall, and last is review. First of all, one is survey, refers to a quick glimpse of entire text. Second one is question. We may ask ourselves if we really want to read, how far will it be beneficial. Third one is reading the text carefully. Fourth one is recall. The fourth stop in reading, comprehension, is recall.
What do you mean by recall? And what do you mean by survey?
Survey means हम लोग जो भी reading करते हैं तो उसके about survey करते हैं. आखिर ये किस चीज के about लिखा हुआ है, किस topic से related.
And why this is important to read? क्यों पढ़ना जरूरी है? मैं क्यों इसको पढ़ूँ या क्यों ना पढ़ूँ? When you survey something, you research.
Yes, ma'am. अगर हम लोग उस चीज में इंटरेस्टेड है उस टॉपिक में, तो हमें उसके बारे में पहले थोड़ा पहले से नॉलेज होना चाहिए, तभी हम लोग उसे अच्छे से अंडरस्टैंडिंग कर पाए.
एंड व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय द टर्म रिकॉल?
रिकॉल मींस हम जो पढ़ते हैं उसे फिर से पढ़ना चाहिए, ताकि अगर बीच में कोई पॉइंट छूटा हुआ है या कोई टर्म हमें समझ में नहीं आया हुआ है, तो हम उसे.
रिकॉल ऑल्सो मीन्स यू ट्राई टू कनेक्ट विद सिमिलर वर्ड्स व्हिच यू हैव रेड इन द पास्ट.
हम लोग उसे अच्छे से अंडरस्टैंड कर सकते.
यस, कंटिन्यू.
एंड fifth one is review. Reviewing is checking whether we have followed the earliest stage promptly and effectively. So these are the basic things of reading skills that make you perfect. It makes you more confident and caring. Thank you all of you.
Yes, very good. You have answered all the questions. The difference between bridge class writing and today's writing is different, because here I am going to ask questions and you will have to answer. If I will not ask questions, I will not know whether you understood or not. So you are reading it, but when you read it, you should also understand what you are reading. That is why the question part is there. Yes, sir, anybody from the boys' side? All right, Abhishek Kumar, start.
According to
your camera's on.
There is a problem in camera.
Hmm?
There is problem in my camera.
Then take somebody else's mobile. Guys at the back, stop talking.
According to Webster, reading is thinking under the stimulus from the printed page. Reading is psycholinguistic guessing game. We understand at the three different levels: pure, literal response to the familiar words given, recognition of the writer's intention of the given text, personal experience which helps us to understand the given text. When we read the lines between the lines and read beyond the lines. So reading is nothing but decoding a process.
What do you understand by the term beyond the line?
Beyond the line means we think about the intention of the writer.
You start guessing what he wants to write.
Yeah.
What he has not written and what might be added.
Yeah.
और वो क्या क्या add कर सकता था इसमें.
जी.
Between you read the sentence, you read between the lines, and then you read beyond the line.
Beyond the line.
Continue.
There are so many. There are five stages to read the and to read anything technically. The first one is survey. In survey refers to a quick glance of the entire text. And the second one is question. We may ask question ourselves if we really want to read a particular text and how far will it be beneficial. The third one is reading. The third, actually reading the text. The fourth one is recalling. Reading comprehension is recalling. We should be able to connect the information at the end. The fifth one is reviewing. In reviewing, we check whether we followed the earlier stages promptly or effectively or not. Thank you.
So I guess you all have understood the reading skills. For advanced reading, there are types of reading which can be skimming, scanning, intensive, extensive. So, but let me include one more person. Abhimanyu Kumar. Abhimanyu, are you in online?
Yes, ma'am.
Make your presentation.
No, ma'am.
Anybody else in the class would like to make a presentation? Anybody else?
Ma'am.
According to Webster, reading is thinking under the stimulus of the printed page. Reading.
All right, forget Webster. What is your definition of reading? What is reading?
Reading मतलब किसी जो भी writer लिखता है उसके मौसी के point of view को समझना, उसको read करना और वो जो कहना चाह रहे हैं मैम उसको अपने भाषा में मैम उसको समझना.
Continue.
Reading is psychological investigation in Webster. Your above definition suggests that when we read in the text, we understand at three different levels. First one is pure literal response to the familiar word given, recognition of the writer's intention, the given text, and the third one is personal experience, which helps us understand the given text. When we read the line, read between the line and read beyond the line. So reading is nothing but a decoding process, and there is a technique of reading that is SQPR. First one is survey, refers to quick glance of the entire text, and second one is question. We may ask ourselves if we really want to read a particular text and how focused it is beneficial. And third one is read. The third step is actually reading the text. And fourth one is recall. The fourth step is reading comprehension is recalling. We should be able to connect the information gained. And the last one is review. Review is checking whether we have followed the earlier speech promptly and effectively.
All right. Anybody else is there?
Good morning, ma'am. Good morning to all of you. Today I'm going to represent my presentation on reading skills. So according to Webster, reading is thinking under the stimulus of the printed page. Reading is also psycholinguistic language and linguistic guessing game. Webster, it is said by Webster. The above definition suggests that when we read any text, we understand at three different levels. Pure literal response to the familiar words given. Second one is recognition of the writer's intention words given. And the third one is personal experience, which aids us to understand the given text. All these three levels could be described thus: when we read the lines, read between the lines and read beyond the lines. So reading is nothing but a decoding process, and it is given in three ways. First one is encoder or writer, second one is message, and the third one is decoder or reader. There are some techniques of reading, which is SQ3R. S means survey, Q means question, R means reading, and second R means recall, and third R means review. So first one is survey. It refers to a quick glance of the entire text. Second one is question. We may ask ourselves if we really want to read a particular, how far will it be beneficial. Third one is read. The third step is actually reading the text. Fourth is recall. The fourth step in reading. Comprehension is recalling. We should be able to connect the information gained. Fifth one is review. Reviewing is checking whether we have followed the order.
Who is the encoder in reading skills?
Writer.
The writer is encoder.
Yes.
And who is the decoder?
Reader.
Reader.
The person who is reading it is the decoder.
Decoder means what? Decoder means
understanding. In speaking skills, encoder is the person who is speaking, and you are decoding. It means you are listening. Encoding, decoding. Decoding is understanding the language spoken, or decoding is reading and understanding the words and tense content written. who is Jaya Bharti. All right, so far so good. Getting back to business letters, the purpose of teaching business English is very simple. For you to understand certain things when you will be joining any organization or otherwise also, what is the importance of written communication, ye aapko samajhna hai. To written ke sabse pehle first thing first was tha, I wanted to tell you what is reading, how to read, what are the technicalities involved. You cannot ignore reading skills before writing. For you to write good, you need to read good. For example, when I told you to write an idea bank, I told you to research. It comes in a process. First you plan, then you research. What is researching? Reading. To know more about the content. So reading is indeed very important. So I did not go into details, but I told you what actually reading is, why reading is important. If you want to do good, if you want to write better, if you want to speak better, reading is one thing which you have to take into account. अभी हम लोग क्या करें, व्हाट आर वी डूइंग राइट नाउ, वी आर रीडिंग. सो बिजनेस, गेटिंग बैक टू द टू चैप्टर वन, यू सॉ इन बिजनेस लेटर्स वी ऑलरेडी लर्नड द फॉर्मैट, द राइटिंग स्टाइल्स ऑफ बिजनेस लेटर. व्हाट आर द राइटिंग स्टाइल्स, व्हाट आर दे? The block style, this modified block, and the indented. So we are recapping it again, and do not be dependent on. You already have a manual. आपके पास किताबें already बढ़ चुकी है आपको. So do not be bothered for क्या पढ़ाया है, आपने PDF भेज दीजिए. जो भी पढ़ा रहे हैं आपके बुक में already है. So do not ask for PDF and this and that. कुछ extra हम पढ़ा रहे हैं अगर, तो आप नोट कर लीजिए उसको. Sometimes when I send, आप कहते हैं खुलता नहीं है या problem is there. तो क्या होता है कि आप जब नोट कर लेते हैं क्लास में, और तो reference के लिए आपके पास किताब तो है ही है, something extra जो आपको पढ़ाई जा रही है तो उसको आप नोट कर लें, so that you can later on you can revise, recap, review, whatever, recall. And then write. So a business letter is a letter which is used by organizations to communicate in a professional way. In the last class, कुछ लोगों ने पूछा था कि what is the meaning of, what is the difference between business letter, formal letter and informal letter. Business letter को formal letters भी कहा जाता है. वो जो कि आप professionally use करते हैं in an organization. जब आप official, जब आप ऑफिशियली कुछ लिख रहे होते हैं, देन दीज लेटर्स आर फॉर्मल लेटर्स, दीज लेटर्स आर बिजनेस लेटर्स, विच इज डन इन एन, विच इज़ यूज बाय द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन और पीपल वर्किंग इन एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. जो भी लोग जो किसी कंपनी में काम कर रहे हैं, ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में काम कर रहे हैं, इंटरनल कम्युनिकेशन हो या एक्सटर्नल कम्युनिकेशन हो, जॉब के मुतालिक, ऑर्गेनाइजेशन के मुतालिक, वॉट एवर वी आर राइटिंग, दैट इज बिजनेस लेटर्स. So a business letter can be defined as a letter which is used by organizations to communicate in a professional way with customers, with other members of the organization, other companies, clients, investors, etc. Business letters uses formal language and a specific format. फॉर्मैट ऑलरेडी आप जान चुके हैं, व्हाट इज द फॉर्मैट, टाइल्स जान चुके हैं, फॉर्मेट आप जान चुके हैं. व्हेन आई वाज टीचिंग यू एप्लीकेशन राइटिंग, दैट वाज आल्सो अ फॉर्मल लेटर जिसमें आप लोगों सीखे, आप लोग सीखे थे ब्लॉक स्टाइल क्या होता है. इन द वेरी ब्रिज क्लास आपको मैंने सिखाया था व्हाट इज ब्लॉक स्टाइल राइटिंग एंड हाउ टू राइट एप्लीकेशंस, उसकी फॉर्मेटिंग क्या होती है. That so block style is the most popular style of writing. So you can use a business letter or a formal letter for writing an application, जो कि आपने पिछले क्लास में किया, पिछले क्लास में ब्रिज क्लास में किया आप. You can write an application for a job. You can write a cover letter. Cover letter मतलब क्या होता है? कवर लेटर होता है रिज्यूमे बनाना सीखेंगे आप. कवर लेटर होता है अपने बारे में बताना कि आपका स्किल्स क्या है, आप यहाँ काम क्यों करना चाहते हैं. तो एक रिज्यूमे के साथ साथ एक कवर लेटर भी जाता है जिसमें आप हाईलाइट करते हैं कि क्या क्या चीज़ में वो आपका स्ट्रेंथ क्या है, आपका प्लस पॉइंट्स क्या है एंड वाई द कंपनी शुड हायर यू. रेज्यूमे में टेक्निकली लिखा होता है और इसमें आप दो तीन चार पैराग्राफ्स लिख सकते हैं. रेज्यूमे में टेक्निकल पॉइंट्स रहता है जिसमें आई यू वी नहीं रहता है, बस पॉइंट वाइज आप लिखते हैं, टेबल्स बना के लिखते हैं. बट कवर लेटर में आप डिटेल में बता सकते हैं कि आप क्यों ये जॉब करना चाहते हैं, आपका स्ट्रेंथ क्या है, किस तरह से आपने अपने आप को तैयार किया है, किस तरह से आपने अपने आप को जॉब रेडी बनाया है, वो सब चीज़ें डालते हैं आप कवर लेटर में. और एक बहुत पोलाइटली रिक्वेस्ट करते हैं कि आपको कंसिडर किया जाए बिकॉज आपको, आप अपने आप को इस जॉब के लिए परफेक्ट समझते हैं. ठीक है, तो ये सब आप डालेंगे विच इज़ नॉट पॉसिबल इन अ रेज्यूमे. तो जो रेज्यूमे में पॉसिबल नहीं है, अपने बारे में कुछ और हाईलाइट करते हुए कुछ और जानकारी आप देते हैं इन अ कवर लेटर. हाँ, लेकिन बेसिकली आप ब्लॉक स्टाइल में ही लिखिएगा. आज हम डिस्कस कर भी रहे हैं पार्ट्स ऑफ लेटर, तो आज डिस्कस करना था. लेट मी सी इफ वी हैव टाइम. एक और डेफिनेशन है, अ लेटर रिटन फॉर बिजनेस पर्पस इज अ बिजनेस लेटर. छोटा डिस्क्रिप्शन डेफिनेशन. आप नोट्स नहीं लिखेंगे तो फिर आप डिपेंडेंट मत होइए कि मैम उनको भेज दीजिएगा. राइट ऑन द डेफिनेशन, जितना शॉर्ट बनाइएगा अपने खुद से डेफिनेशन बनाइए. अ लेटर रिटन फॉर बिजनेस. सो व्हाट इज अ बिजनेस लेटर? अ लेटर रिटन फॉर बिजनेस पर्पस इज अ बिजनेस लेटर. For example, inquiry letter, offer letter, order letter, cover letter, notices, termination of employment are some of the business letters. किसी भी तरह का correspondence जो होता है, that is a business letter. Can be internal, within the organization भी होता है और organization के बाहर भी, internal and external. You can write an application letter for your to your employee. You can write a resignation letter. वो हर लेटर जिसमें business included है, such letters are business letters. Your exam, or you might define what you understand by a business letter. A business letter is a formal letter. क्या है? एक formal letter. Then what is the informal letter? वो letters जो हम friends को लिखते हैं, relatives को लिखते हैं, parents को लिखते हैं. Yes, which may have, may not have a format or a style. But a business letter should always have a format, should always have a specific style, whatever style aap choose kar rahe. You can choose semi-block, you can choose block style. Now the three writing styles or writing formats. Students confuse karte hain jab pucha jata hai what are the parts of a letter, to batate hain format bata dete hain. Format puchte hain to parts bata dete hain. The questions different hai. There are only three formats. The block style. ब्लॉक स्टाइल जो कि आप जानते हैं, आप लिख चुके हैं, लेफ्ट अलाइंड होता है. ब्लॉक स्टाइल इज द मोस्ट कॉमन लेआउट ऑफ अ बिजनेस लेटर. यूजिंग दिस फॉर्मेट द एंटायर लेटर इज लेफ्ट जस्टिफाइड एंड सिंगल स्पेस्ड. सिंगल स्पेसिंग होता है इसमें, एक्सेप्ट फॉर डबल स्पेस बिटवीन पैराग्राफ्स. पैराग्राफ में आपको अलग करने के लिए डबल स्पेस रहता है, अदरवाइज इट इज सिंगल स्पेस्ड. Block format features all elements of the letter aligned to the left margin of the page. It has a neat and simple appearance. Isko describe kiya gaya hai. Iska appearance kaisa hai? Neat and simple. Paragraphs are spaced by double spaced, otherwise it is single spaced. Abhi pichle exam mein maine diya tha students ko. What do you understand by, what are the writing styles of a business letter? तो उन लोगों ने बस बता दिया था block style, semi block and indent. They did not describe. अगर आप describe करके लिखेंगे exam में 10 marks, 20 marks का रहता ही है, तो you have to specify, describe block style क्या है. How is it different from semi-block, modified block, isn't it? Which you already know. आप कुछ लिख रहे थे क्या? नेक्स्ट यू सी द ब्लॉक स्टाइल जो कि ऑलरेडी आप जानते हैं. ये देखिए सिंगल स्पेस है और पैराग्राफ्स में डबल स्पेस है. डबल स्पेस का मतलब क्या होता है? सेपरेट हो जाता है. और रीडिंग रीडिंग क्या होता है? इट इज इजी टू रीड. अलग अलग पैराग्राफ और reading becomes simple. सिक्योरिटी करना पड़ेगा आपके लिए, बताइए. आप जान रहे हैं मॉडिफाइड ब्लॉक क्या है? यू ऑलरेडी नो अबाउट इट. व्हाट इज मॉडिफाइड ब्लॉक?
Slightly modified from block style.
हाउ इज इट डिफरेंट, आप बताइए हमको, आप पढ़ चुके हैं बताइए. Tell me, how is it different? Semi block style. It's indented. It means it is in the center. And five spaces from the left, which you already understood. Time हो गया आपको बताने की जरूरत नहीं है.